don't want to be like this. This is disgusting. This is awful in every way. If I could kill it, I would. But I legally can't. But I've considered it.
It's time to stop! It's time to stop, okay? No more! Where the fuck are your parents? Who are your parents? I'm gonna call Child Protective Services. It's time to stop!
The final enemy that we needed to kill to complete this mission was underground. This is such a destroyed pile of code.
Enemies spawning under the map. If you know specific places where that's happening, I'll just send that to me, please, so we can look into it.
At the request of a developer, I'd like to showcase the numerous bugs that I consistently experience that have persisted since launch 8 months ago. Hello, beta testers. Before Spider-Man dropped into Marvel's Avengers, the internet agreed that it was perhaps the most rigid and stiff Spidey that we'd ever seen. So, to keep up the tradition of disappointment, Crystal Dynamics decided to outdo themselves by making Spider-Man so stiff that even his hanging pose is completely stiff and has zero sway. If you look closely, there's not even a web here. That's the kind of quality you can expect out of Crystal Dynamics Marvel's Avengers over 450 days after launch, and this rigor mortis Spider-Man will smack you dead in the face as soon as you load the game up, right after you have to click through whatever marketplace thing they're trying to shove in your face. So it's funny, because Fortnite didn't just choose better crowd-pleasing skins than your game. They didn't just manage better swinging with fluid animations and uncompromised momentum. They didn't just allow him to web slide and use more than one emote at a time. They even nailed him hanging, which we honestly didn't think was so hard that you could vomit all over that too. Wow. So what are people supposed to think, Crystal Dynamics? At best, you hate your jobs, and at worst, you hate Spider-Man? IGN said Avengers Spider-Man felt like, and I quote, a promise delivered through gritted teeth rather than one delivered with a smile. How savagely eloquent, yet wonderfully apt, is that description? Your Spider-Man feels like an obligation, a chore, something that you have to drop because you said you would. But honestly, you really just want to make money off of these Spider-Man suits that you're gonna sell. These recolors. Minimum effort, maximum profit, minimum viable product. Your Spider-Man has no story missions, no villains, no new places, but a temporary event in that free game Fortnite brought a whole ass Daily Bugle building. Surprise NPCs like Mary Jane and others will be showing up in the future. But do you think Fortnite will make Mary Jane ugly like you would? Make her wear a hijab or something because being feminine is disgusting to you? But only the girls need to cover up, right, Crystal Dynamics? The guys can have fun. Go fuck yourself. Never forget that a Fortnite skin for Lara Croft made more than you could on your whole ass game. Why? Because Epic's intelligent enough to deliver equally sexy skins for guys and girls. Because the only thing sexier than curves are edges. This is why Eastern developers gonna get all the money, because pretending sexy doesn't exist because you're insecure isn't the way. I'm forever amused by shill Avengers creators defending this trash, because when Crystal asks them to spread them ass cheeks, they respond, "How wide?" But they'll do anything for views, like a cringe TikToker. And the joke is, if you've ever seen these people making excuses through crashes and checkpoint reloads, it's clear that Crystal doesn't have to ask. These dudes got some tough knees, you gotta give them that. I was gonna add some whipcrack noises to really drive home how proud their ancestors must be, but I was in tears laughing at the videos people sent me from this buggy raid, because my bug videos have now aged like fine wine and prove, as I've said over and over, that the game can't handle a raid. And the series of puzzles and minimal monotonous boss fights that you've cobbled together isn't exactly what anyone who's actually played a raid before would consider one. You'd think granting checkpoints similar to Mega Hives, knowing how buggy your game is a necessity? But nope. You'd think you'd offer periodic rewards, since a typical disconnect with no join in progress could instantly destroy a run. But nope. You'd think for your first raid that came over a year after launch that the loot would be worth playing through it. Instead, it's laughably bad. You're nothing short of astounding, Crystal Dynamics. I thought that you'd at least allow Widow and Hawkeye to swing from the air like Spider-Man does, you know, so non-PlayStation players could feel like they got something, but even that was too much. Your focus is on prepping your RNG loot boxes for free to play so that you can charge people real money for units, which is identically as transparent as when they nerfed the XP and broke their promise not to sell boosters, which are still available, via their bundles. A recent patch stole players' units and resources after a year of progress, only to implement a system where they could finally have something to spend it on. There's been nothing in the in-game shop, the non-microtransaction cosmetic section, but now that they've patched it in, oops, they took your money. We'll saw we. Just another update delivering stealth nerfs as usual to add to the pile. Hey look, that whack job community coordinator says that maybe the game won't erase your saves now. Maybe. How could they know? As I say in my tweet, they don't test the game. You do. So beta testers, they've already showed their hand by nerfing how you can farm units today. But it's okay. There's so little people playing and covering this game that the shills will rejoice and gargle that jizz no matter how bad it tastes. And Crystal Dynamics will keep silencing everyone who doesn't have exclusively positive things to say, because that's how you grow apparently, and it's gone so well for you so far. Spider-Man brings joy to the hearts of millions, and this lackluster, shrug-worthy desecration of something that existed long before this entire team was born and will long after they have all been forgotten should inspire shame if you were capable. Since your devs have made it clear that unless you're playing the game right now, they can't take your feedback, Crystal Dynamics, as someone who's been exposing your bugs prior to day one, know that your game has exceeded expectations and easily claims the title of worst Marvel game that most will ever play, and your Spider-Man follows suit. Do you see what I did there? I know that perked you up when you heard suit. You're thinking, money? Money? Words can't express how pathetic you look banning and silencing people like me for telling the truth about your disaster of a game. You're less than a defender to me. At least many of them are deluded and immature children chasing coin with Spider-Man thumbnails, but you know better. So Crystal Dynamics, thank you for reinforcing the idea that all critique is negativity. You failed. In your multiple attempts at gaslighting the community, you have failed at reducing their eloquently articulated issues to toxicity. It's gotta be hard to stay smug when a year-old video of mine is showcasing bugs that are still bending you and your game over right now. But it was whining. It was complaining. When the game actually had intelligent people playing, we all tried to keep you on the right path, but money drove you. And just like the Halo community is being vocal right now, we were, and you chose to ignore. So bask in the world continuing to ignore you, because you deserve it. Thank you for liking, listening, and making your voice heard so that this doesn't become a trend in gaming. And if you're just here to laugh, They deserve it.
What the fuck was that guy doing?
Please leave a comment with a rating for this Spider-Man.
What the fuck?
I rate this Spider-Man's inclusion in the defective, yet inexplicably full-priced live service Marvel's Avengers that expects you to buy skins, buy emotes, buy takedowns, buy banners, buy individual battle passes for each hero when they consistently nerf progression and steal player units, a 1 out of 10. You deserved better than being made a non-consensual beta tester 450 days after this game's launch, and Spider-Man deserves better. I love you. Happy holidays.